When working with sprite objects in Construct 3, they have some built-in abilities, one of which is to set the scale of the object. This is nice to have, but unfortunately, there's no way to read the current scale and use the value as a condition in an event. The add-on we'll be talking about today solves this issue and gives us other useful options when scaling an object, and that is the scale behavior. This plugin works in both Construct 2 and 3, and I've included a link to where you can find it in the description. I've got a layout set up with two cactus objects and a tree object. I'll add the scale behavior to both the cactus and the tree objects. Select Behaviors, Add New, and add the scale behavior. I'll do the same thing for the tree object. Add New, and add the scale behavior. There are no properties to adjust with the scale behavior. Everything is done in the event sheet. Before we switch over, I want to make the size of the first cactus a little smaller. I'll select it and hold down Shift while sizing it down so that it scales down uniformly. You'll see why later, but for now, just notice how the first cactus is manually scaled down and the second cactus is set to its original scale, the dimensions of the actual sprite. Let's switch to the event sheet and see what this behavior can do. We're going to use a couple keys on the keyboard to trigger the scaling of these objects. So I'll add an event using the keyboard object, and I'll use onKeyPressed. I'll use the spacebar first, and then hit Done. Add an action using the cactus object. If we scroll down to the scale category, we've got two options, set scale by image and set scale by self. We'll take a look at both, but for now, let's just use set scale by self. What this allows us to do is set the scale of the object with 1 being equal to the dimensions of the object at the start of the layout. I'll explain that more in a moment, but let's set the scale first. If the object is at a scale of 1, it's at its original dimensions. If we scale it up to 2, it will be at double its original size. 3 would be triple its original size, and so on. We have 3 options under scale dimension: general, width, and height. Width and height allow you to scale the object by just the width or the height, while general lets you scale the object by both the width and the height. Under value, I want to reference the current scale of the object, which you can't do with the standard scale functionality. To do this, type cactus dot scale dot self. That will give us the current scale of the object, with 1 being equal to the dimensions of the object at the start of the layout. And I'll add to that scale by 0.5. So, every time the spacebar is pressed, it will grab the current scale of the object and add 0.5 to it. I'll preview the layout. And when I press space, the objects scale up, pressing it several times, and the objects keep scaling. I want to add a way to reset the objects to their original self scale, or the scale at the start of the layout. I'll copy the first event and paste it, and just change the spacebar to the S key. And change the action so it sets the scale to 1. I'll copy this again . This time, change the key to I. Double-click to edit the action, but go back. And here, we'll use Set Scale by Image. And just leave it set to 1. If I preview the layout, I can press space to scale the cacti up according to their self-scale, and press S to return them to their original self-scale dimension. But if I press I, it will set their scale to 1 based on the dimensions of the actual sprite. Remember, the cactus on the right is set to its original scale, while the one on the left has been resized down. When I press I, the resized cactus returns to the dimensions of its actual image. Pressing S returns it to its self-scale, or the dimensions at the start of the layout. Set scale by image sets the scale with 1 being equal to the dimensions of the image inside the animation's editor. Set scale by self sets the scale with 1 being equal to the actual size of the objects inside the layout. Next, I'm going to copy this event and paste it below. I'll change the key to the up arrow. And go back and change the object to the tree. We'll use set scale by self and set the value of height to 1.5. Copy and paste that event 3 more times. And I'll edit the keys to down, left, and right. When down is pressed, we'll return the height of the tree to a scale of 1. We'll use the left key to set the scale of the tree's width to 1. And the right key to set the tree's width to a scale of 1.5. I'll preview the layout, and by pressing the up arrow, we can scale the tree's height up, but not its width. Pressing the down key, and we can return the tree to its original height. We can press up to scale the height up, and then right to scale the width up. So that's how you can scale by height or width, and not both. I want to do one more thing that you can't do with the standard scale functionality. Let's add an event using the tree object and scroll down to the scale category. We've got 2 conditions we can use to trigger an event: compare scale by image and compare scale by self. These reference the same scale dimensions we talked about earlier, the original image dimensions, or the actual object's dimensions, which may have been resized in the layout. These conditions let us compare the current value of the object's scale and perform an action based on its value. We'll compare scale by self. Here, we can decide if we want to check the scale of the height, width, or both. We'll use height, so this won't be triggered by the width being scaled up. Then, we can decide how we want to compare: greater than, less than, equal to, and any other way you'd need to compare. We'll use greater than, and I'll say greater than a value of 1. Then we'll add an action with the cactus object and choose set scale by self. I'll just scale them up to 2 so that we can see the event occurring. And real quick, I'll add an else event. Copy the action where we set the cactus scale and just return it back to 1. I'll preview the layout, and when I scale up the width of the tree, nothing happens. But if I scale the height of the tree, the cacti both grow in size with it, to a scale of 2. If I scale the tree back down to 1, the cacti also return to their original self-scale. That's how you can use the scale of objects to cause other actions to happen. This can be much more in-depth as well. This tree could cause the cacti to grow once it reaches a scale of 1.5, and maybe trigger another event to cause the sky to get darker after it reaches a scale of 2. That would be a fast-growing tree, but you get my point. You can create an in-depth series of actions based on the scale of other objects. Thanks for watching. If you find this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon at patreon.com/todaystuts. For $1 a month, you'll get early access to all new videos, and you'll help keep this channel alive. See you next time.